Welcome to Connection with Brian and Nicole Wright.
Hello, welcome to another episode of Connection with Brian and Nicole. Nicole is not with us today, but I do have Brother Tracy Harris with us. Glory to God.
I'm glad to be here, Brother
Amen.
Brian.
I'm glad you're here, too. Yeah. I've been looking forward to this.
I bet Nicole's glad you didn't call me Nicole.
I know. Well, and the people on the radio, they'll be saying, man, her voice got deep.
That's exactly what'll happen, you know, when they hear it.
Yeah, well, we just welcome you to another episode of Connection. We are in Fort Worth, Texas, again, at the Southwest Believers Convention. It has been a great week, and we just praise God that you are joining with us today. Whether you're listening or watching, we just want you to know you can always go to connectionshow.org. You can watch any past episodes. Also, when you go there, make sure that you send us a note. We'd love to hear from you. Where are you watching or listening from? Comments, questions, prayer requests. We'd love to pray with you, and we just love you. Thank you for joining us on Connection, and I'm excited. Let's get started. Let's jump in.
Praise God.
So, you and I have known each other for maybe 5 years or so.
Probably so. Sounds about right.
Yeah, we just had some meeting. Actually, we've been in several meetings this year.
We have. Praise God. They have been powerful.
It's been
glorious.
They have. Glory to God. Amen. Yeah. The Lord has shown up in those meetings over the country, actually all over the world. We were across the seas together,
too.
That's true. And that was a blessing to me.
That is true, yeah, absolutely.
I enjoy being around you and just appreciate you. Pastor Tracy is one of my mentors, and he is there and helps me when I might run into something every now and then I don't know about, and generally if I pick up the phone, you know it, and if you don't, you can get in touch with the Lord, and you've got some experience that I don't have, and I just appreciate that.
Well, you're gracious to say that, but yeah. I tell you, one of the things that I appreciate is that, you know, in fact, I just have something in my spirit that just came up. This is just as you said that, it just came up.
Yeah.
And, you know, in fact, I know this is for somebody watching today.
Amen.
And
Amen.
It's a powerful moment. While you were talking about that, how that, you know, mentor and that relationship and the anointing and partnership, it's in 2 Samuel 23, but it's a powerful, powerful thing. And I want to encourage anybody that's watching out there today to understand that the harvest doesn't happen without partnership.
Yeah, that's...
Yes. Partnership is the distribution of the anointing in the earth. In other words, somebody's watching this today because somebody else sowed a seed. Other people are seeing to it and are part of the harvest of getting the word of revelation reproduced. Somebody's life is going to change today. And I wanted to say about you, I appreciate all the kindness and all the kind things, but any good thing that's in me, it's because I died, I'm born again,
Amen.
And this new life I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me, who lives in me. And He's the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Yes, sir.
Any good or great or glorious or mighty creative miracle we've seen all over the world, may all the glory go to King Jesus.
Yes.
And that same anointing.
Yes.
That same great anointing.
Yes.
That same great anointing and power and that name and that spirit is in and on you and has been. Philippines, Africa, around the world, and is on you now to do this TV program.
Amen.
And I want to encourage some people that may be watching that watch this regularly to partner with your anointing.
Yeah.
And, of course, always they may be led to partner with any anointing you have here because that's the way this thing gets distributed.
No doubt
about that. But it just comes up in me while you're talking about it, and I want to make a statement because you talked about this connection,
how
it supernaturally came together. And in 2 Samuel chapter 23, it talks about David's mighty men.
Yes, sir.
Now, this is a story that a lot of people may have heard that may not have heard. It's such a favorite of mine that in this program, we would probably exhaust the whole program if we read all of this and talked about it just alone.
Yes, sir.
But there's three that it says that excelled. And with those three, one of them defended a field of beans against a whole garrison of the innocent. The other one killed 800 guys, you know, tenacity despite overwhelming odds. A mighty man with a spear by himself. Let me just tell you,
glory to God.
What you're facing today.
There is,
you and God are the majority. There is an
anointing
that will break you through.
That's right.
And there's a breakthrough anointing on this program. And that's what the Lord began to talk to me about, breaking through into our harvest.
Yes, sir.
So I want to make a statement about that right here. And I want to show you something that's in my spirit.
Yeah.
About twofold. One, a word for the people watching Connect today.
Yeah.
And number two, something I believe is should happen with every anointed ministry gift that's on this program. They've got to have the right kind of help. There's you got to be connected with the right anointing.
Yes.
If we don't think that our relationships will affect us and help us or hinder us, just ask Caleb and Joshua.
Right.
I bet Caleb and Joshua would have a thing or two to say about the people they ran with, whether or not it'll cause you a 40-year delay or whether or not it'll get you there in a hurry.
Yes, sir.
The beautiful thing about Caleb and Joshua is that in the wilderness experience, they proved that it's not what other people say about it that comes to pass.
Yes,
right?
Sir.
But what they said about it. So here's what they proved, that the authority of their words had more authority than a whole nation of people saying the opposite.
Yes.
So never walk in fear about, I don't know why it's not working and people are saying these negative things. Understand, Jesus said, whatsoever you say, when you say it to this mountain, believe it in your heart. You have what you say when you say it. It's what you say about it.
That's right.
It's going to come to pass.
Right.
Once you realize that King Jesus, the same anointing is in you, that, of course, was delegated to us from the head of the church.
Yeah.
So you might actually want to say something about that, and then we'll just jump back here to this. You have something in your heart coming up?
Well, I just know that partnership is so important. And, you know, like when we started to partner with your ministry, we went to another level. And we're not going to accomplish the things that God has for us without each other. Over in Galatians 3:8, where it says, God preached the gospel beforehand to Abraham, saying, through you all the nations will be blessed. And I know that the Lord said this to me one time. He said, there's so many people that are looking up constantly, but the ways of the Lord was that God was going to pour out the blessing through people. Through people, through you, the nations, the people groups will be blessed. It's one of the ways of God. It's we are designed to be a blessing to each other by the words of God Himself. And when we understand that, we start to realize, I need you in my life, right? We need you in our lives because it's through people that the blessing flows.
And, absolutely.
So it's so important.
I've got a couple of thoughts before we come back to 2 Samuel about that.
Yeah.
And the fact is that this program right here by itself is a partnership.
Yes. Yeah.
In other words, when you said, hey, would you come, you saw an anointing or something or revelation here that's saying we can help the people together.
Yes.
You know, a partnership, a river's made great by all the streams and tributaries that feed it.
Yes.
Yeah. And as we look at this, Jesus made statement. Jesus made a very powerful statement in John 4. Here's what he said. Other men have labored, but you've entered into their labors.
Yes.
He said, they sowed, but he said, I sent you to reap.
Yes.
So clearly the harvest is dependent upon partnership. The harvest cannot happen without that partnership. And it's a very powerful thought in the scripture. I saw something yesterday morning even. You know, the Word of God's alive. It's a living document.
Yes.
It's living, it's breathing. The Bible says when you sleep, it'll keep you.
Yes.
When you awake, it'll talk with you. And when you go, it'll lead you in the book of Proverbs 6. God's Word is alive and powerful, sharper than a two-edged sword. It's not like the newspaper or a romance novel or something like that. It is absolutely the DNA of the very breath of the Holy Spirit of God. It's the voice of God Almighty. By it, every man, woman of God is thoroughly furnished to every good work.
Yes, sir.
This Word will keep talking to you. If you'll stay in it, it'll get in you. In fact, speaking of that mighty man, one of those guys put his hand on a sword. This is the most amazing thing. And he fought all day with it so hard that at the end of the day, he had to have his hand pried off the sword.
Yes.
This is the way we got to get with the Word. The way we have to get with the Word is we have to take hold of the Word, right, until our life conforms around the Word.
Yes.
And then pretty soon, they can't pry us loose from it.
Yeah.
And you can't tell where we stop and the Word begins and the Word stops and we begin. We become one with the Word.
Amen.
That's what the blood covenant is. In Hebrews 9, Moses did this. He took a hyssop and he dipped it in blood. He sprinkled the book. And he sprinkled the people. And here he said, this is the book of the covenant, whereby God has, the blood of the covenant, whereby God has joined this covenant unto you. He did a marriage ceremony between the people and the Word.
Yeah.
The blood, God cannot see us. He sees us through the blood. He cannot see us any other way than this book.
Yes.
In other words, we may feel circumstances or symptoms or pain.
Yes.
He can't see us any other way than by His stripes you were healed.
Yeah.
He sees us, literally, He joined us. There was a marriage ceremony in heaven when Jesus rose from the dead, and by His blood, He married us to this book. As far as God's concerned, we in this book, we're one.
Yes.
I'm a partner with this everlasting covenant. He
Glory
cannot lie.
God.
It will not stop.
Yes.
It's alive and powerful. It'll put me over in every circumstance. And The reason I'm saying that is yesterday, I was meditating on something in Ephesians 5. It said he's the Savior of the body. Two verses later in Ephesians 5:25, it says that husbands should love their wives as Christ loves the church and gave himself for it. Now, in that situation, it's really kind of interesting, a powerful thing, because it just came off the page. I don't know how many weddings I performed. I don't know how I've lived that with my wife for nearly 40 years and done everything I could to walk that out as I understood it.
Yeah.
But suddenly it came off the page because the word church is the word ecclesia.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. It means assembly.
Yes.
And of course, Christ is the anointed one in his anointing. And here's what he's saying. He is saying Jesus loved the assembly.
Yes. Yes.
So much, he died to create that assembly.
Yes.
In other words, the point is he loves the church, the anointing. Anybody that loves the anointing, anybody that loves Jesus is going to love the church. They're going to love. We have a real movement today that's trying to get people to say, well, you don't need a pastor. You don't need a local church. You don't need a covering. And it's actually satanic. And
it's here's a very real deception.
Here is why. Yeah. He said, forsake not the assembling of yourselves together, even more as you see the day approaching.
Yes.
How come? Where two or three are gathered together, in his name, there he is.
Yeah.
The anointing loves the assembly. Why? Because the assembly, listen, the assembly is a partnership. It's where all the parts come together. And there's an anointing that's greater than an individual anointing. There's an anointing that's greater than a ministry anointing. It's the anointing of the body of Christ. It's the fullness of him that filleth all in all. When you can get people in a church where the word's taught, where the name is exalted, where the Holy Ghost is in operation, where the power of God flows, and they're not lied to that the gifts of the Spirit aren't for today, but they believe Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, Jesus loves the assembly so much, he'll show up with his angels and walk the aisle, and somebody will come in with cancer and leave without it. He'll destroy that cancer in the middle of that anointing that's in that assembly. The anointing loves the assembly.
Yeah.
So if we love God's power and we love God's anointing, we're going to love coming to church.
Yes.
We're going to love God's people. We're going to love, you know, all kinds of meetings.
We've been seeing that in the meetings we've been in this year. That's what's been happening. Healings have been happening just while the meeting's going on. People coming up, jobs being had, people coming to Jesus, being filled with the Holy Ghost.
Miracles. After miracle.
What you're saying is not theory. What he's saying is truly manifesting.
Every meeting around the world.
Yes,
you've been in those meetings.
Yes,
you've
seen.
Yeah. You've seen the miraculous moments of the creative miracles in those meetings.
Yeah.
And the thing about that assembly is it is one, it's another level of this dynamic spiritual law called partnership.
Yes.
You see, when every joint supplies, when that partnership happens, it generates a synergy.
Yes.
That is the same power that raised Jesus from the dead.
Yeah.
When he came out of the ground, his head didn't just come out of the ground, his whole body did. In other words, the Bible tells us that when he was raised, so were we.
Yes.
Even when we were dead in our trespasses and sins.
Yeah.
And so we see then that that resurrection power belongs to the body. And he put miracles, 1 Corinthians 12:28 says, he set miracles in the church.
Yes.
You know, people always talk about miracles on the foreign field, but I see miracles in every meeting all across America.
Yes.
Have been seeing it since Jesus made himself known to me.
Yes.
That he was the same and that there never was a day of miracles. There's always been a God of miracles.
Yeah.
And for the people watching today, I think one of the reasons this is fleshing up in me so strongly is because the very name of this program, Connections.
Yeah.
The Bible says that there's a life flow. Right?
Yes.
Colossians 2, and it says that when they get puffed up in their mind and so forth, they're not holding the head from which all the nourishment and the bands and the ligaments of the body are supplied. We get the head in the right place.
Yes. Yes.
When we get the right connections.
Yeah.
And the first connection is the Word became flesh and dwelt among
us. Right.
Connect right here.
Yeah.
And I guarantee you, the Word will come off the printed page and manifest itself and become flesh and dwell among us. And listen to this. And we beheld his glory.
Glory. Yeah.
That's the glory. The Word becoming flesh.
Yeah.
Somebody walking in a meeting, they have a pancreas that doesn't function.
Yeah.
And they get a brand new pancreas, a transplant.
Yeah.
By the anointing of the healing and working of miracles.
Yeah.
And Jesus proves he's alive. Here you've got somebody walking in the meeting, and within an hour or two, they walk out. What happened to me?
Yeah.
And there was a synergy of the resurrection power, the head of the church, created at that moment in that gathering. No wonder. He loves the assembly.
Yeah.
That's where his anointing moves to create the authority of Almighty God to set the captive free.
We just saw that. We had a testimony in a meeting that we were recently in, and basically what happened was this. the Lord led you to move in that anointing. I won't tell you exactly what he did, but basically in the middle of that meeting, when the body came together, there was an anointing, and Brother Tracy moved. All of a sudden he flowed in that anointing. He released that anointing to a person in the meeting.
Yes.
That person then was so lit up, they couldn't hardly sleep that night. And they were sitting there praying. The Holy Spirit comes and tells them, go to the hospital and pray for somebody. Really pray, and he thought he was going to go pray for the family because they were going to pull the plug on the loved one the next day, and they were fully expecting for the loved one to pass away.
Yeah.
But because the body came together, and because you knew how to operate and flow in that anointing and how to release it, here he goes and prays for the person, not Brother Tracy, not me. This is not a fivefold, this is not apostle, prophet, evangelist,
pastor. Yeah, but that anointing came on them as they were gathered with it.
Yes, as they
came on them as they were gathered with that partnership.
Yeah, they pulled the plug. He went and prayed for the person. They pulled the plug. They're expecting, and no, that's not what they got. What they got was the person woke up and said, "Where's my phone?" And ever since then, got out of the hospital, now is recovering, doing stuff they couldn't do before they went in. They thought they were going to die. That was just a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
So anyway, this is not theory. This is the manifested glory of God through the Word. And when we will marry ourselves to the Word of God,
absolutely,
there's life inside
of it. There is life inside
of it. Amen.
Praise God. I'm hoping we have time to say something here. Yeah. I don't know what we're looking at here, and I think the folks are watching, but glory to God. Listen, here's the deal. Here's the deal about this thing.
Yeah.
Is I was reading this the other day in 2 Samuel 23 about David's mighty men.
Yes.
Two thoughts here. First thought is this. All right, there's three of them we talked about. The guy with the spear, the guy that took the sword, the guy that the field of beans. But he had more than that. He had 30, and then that 30 was several hundred.
Right.
But these three are chronicled because they excelled,
right,
in a different level of relationship with King David.
Yes.
And the truth is, they were in debt, distressed, and discontented.
Yes.
But when they came to him and got connected with his anointing, they all became mighty men.
That's right.
This is what that partnership
will
do. Now, it's very interesting because it says this in 2 Samuel 23.
What verse?
In verse 13.
Okay.
And we're going to look at two verses because, as I said, reading it all would take all the rest of our time. But it says, and three of the 30 chief, these are those mighty men, went down and, look at this, they came to David. Now, when you started opening up about we've been knowing one another for 5 years, what happened? See, there are people that know inside themselves.
Yes.
They're supposed to come and attach to an anointing, to a power. That is critical.
Yes.
It's critical for that to not only come upon them, but for that anointing to come upon them to achieve what their destiny is.
That's right. That's right.
So there's three things that says
here. Can we pause for just a second?
Sure, please.
So right now, I just want to tell you, listen, what Brother Tracy is talking about is this, is that you have a call on your life.
Absolutely.
But
right.
There are things that you cannot do outside of a connection. And that is part of the reason why this show is named Connection with Brian
Absolutely.
And Nicole. Connection. Because we want to connect with you as you connect with Christ to fulfill what God has called you to do. And so there are things that God's, right now, I believe there's people listening and watching that are hearing this and they're saying, I am called to something. And what you're missing is the connection between the people that you're called to. Whether it be us or, and let me just throw this in here now because you and I love to get in the Word. Your website is experiencehim.org.
Yes.
And I would encourage you highly to connect with Brother Tracy and his ministry, what he's doing around the world. You can get more of this kind of teaching. But you can find this again at connectionshow.org. Whether you're supposed to connect with Brother Tracy, connect with Brian and Nicole, or at Boomerang Church, find the person that God is writing in your heart to connect with. I can tell you that Brother Tracy is a great one to do that with. And get connected because there's something in your destiny that you can't do without these connections, which is what I believe you're about to say.
Oh, that is exactly right. What I'm really going to talk about is the ultimate essence of what we're really accomplishing here is we're going to break through. There's an anointing to break through into our harvest.
Yes.
When we feel like we've been held out of our faith project being realized.
Yes.
Breaking over into the manifestation, there's an anointing here to break through into our harvest.
Yes.
And we're going to talk about that here for just a moment.
Okay.
It says, three of the 30 chief went down and came to David And look at what it says here.
That's awesome.
In the harvest time.
Yes.
So the next four words are in the harvest time. It was harvest time.
Yes.
Partnership, harvest requires partnership. And it's harvest time. But they came into the cave of Adullam, and the troop of the Philistines pitched in the valley of Rephaim. Rephaim are like the Nephilim or the Anakim.
Right.
This is the valley of the giants. These are men of great stature. This is like Goliath.
Right.
All right. So David has an anointing on his life, and he's stepping into what God's destiny is. But it's about, we're about to see here that there's a giant, there's some giants standing in his way.
Right.
All right. To keep him out of his harvest, but it's time for him to have it.
Yes.
It's harvest time. It's time for him to break through, but there's some giants in the way.
Right.
All
Any
right?
of y'all felt like that before?
You understand what I'm saying to you here? Look at what it says. This is, and David was then in a hold. There's a lot of people that we're watching, around, they feel like they're in a holding pattern.
Right.
They're like, I don't understand what's holding my harvest back. I don't understand what's keeping me from receiving
yeah.
it. If the word's right and I'm doing everything I know how to do, I'm using the name, I'm
what's
sowing.
What's the deal?
What's the deal?
Yeah.
Right? As we see this is huge. It says, David was then in a hold, and the garrison of the Philistines was then in Bethlehem. And David longed and said, oh, that one would give me a drink of the water of the well of Bethlehem, which is by the gate. And the three mighty men break through. They broke through. Do you see that? They
yeah.
broke through. The host
yeah.
of the Philistines, excuse me, Philippines, yeah.
yeah.
Philistines. They broke through. Now, here's the point is there was anointing on the men. See, one of the things is having the right supernatural
yes.
voices, connections, anointings in your
yes.
life. They came to David. Now, here's the thing.
Yeah.
David needed to break through the enemy lines. He
yeah.
needed help.
Yes.
He needed the right kind of help.
Yes.
Moses had to have the right kind of help.
Yes.
Joshua had to have the right kind of help. Elijah and Elisha had to have the right kind of help. Even Jesus had 12 disciples and then another 70. This gospel actually wasn't designed. Look at Adam. It is not good that man should be alone. I will create
That's
him
right.
a help. Helps were supernaturally created by God
yes.
to get a destiny done.
Yes.
God didn't design any man with a call to ever do it by himself.
Yes.
He
yes.
never designed it that way.
Yes.
And so what happened was, is David has an assignment. These guys don't have the same anointing.
Yes.
But they have what David needs to break through into that assignment.
Yes.
See what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
They come to David. David's anointing gets on them. They become giant killers. And they break through the thing that's holding all of them
yeah.
out of the harvest at harvest time.
Yeah.
And so this connection, these anointings are designed.
That's right.
Now, that's what happened to this family.
That's right.
All right? This was a series of events.
Yes.
To where had he not been in connection with that anointing and that service.
Yes.
And the Holy Ghost not coming on him the same way. And then him acting on that anointing and carrying that into that hospital
yes.
room.
Yes.
Because I didn't go in there. You didn't go in there. But it was the anointing in that meeting yep. that caused that to happen. It's been happening. It's a dead, raising, body
yeah.
working, you know,
yeah.
anointing. Now, yep. here's the thing. And this is so powerful. David, he said this about the covenant God put on his life. And I want to read verse 5. I'm going to read it out of the Amplified.
Okay.
2 Samuel 23. It says this. He says, truly does not my house, that means my kingdom, God's promise to my life, does not my house stand so with God? He says, he has made me an everlasting covenant. In other words, this is forever. God
yes.
has given me a promise that will never change. And my seat will sit on the throne. No
yeah.
man will stand before me. No giant will ever stop me. No
yes.
weapon formed against me will ever
Glory
prosper. This is guaranteed to happen to me and to
yeah.
my house. It will happen. I will break through into what yeah. God promised me. And notice what he said. He said, truly, does not my house stand so with God?
Yeah.
For he has made with me an everlasting covenant, ordered in all things and sure, guaranteed, for will he not cause to prosper all my help.
All my help.
And my
Amen.
Desire. David is saying, everybody that helps me get done what God called me to do, God will cause my help to prosper. I'm telling you,
yeah.
I'm not saying this to try to generate partnership. I'm trying to get prosperity to you.
Yeah.
I'm trying to help you understand the laws that govern prosperity and the giants that are keeping you out of your breakthrough at harvest time. It's your harvest time, and no wonder Jesus loves the assembly.
Yes. Yes.
The anointing is in the assembly.
Yes.
One final thought is Isaiah 65:8. It says, as new wine is found in the cluster,
yeah.
a blessing is in it, don't destroy it, because the blessing's in it.
Yeah.
Else I will destroy you. So new wine isn't found in one grape. It's in the cluster.
So good.
The blessing is in the cluster, and God says, don't destroy the cluster.
Yes.
When you pull away, from the church or whatever else, yeah. or from partnerships and divine relationships.
Yes.
That's why the spirit of division, and we might get to talk about that sometime on one yeah. of these programs, how to stop the enemy's works, put an end to Satan's works.
Yes.
Is that spirit of division.
Yeah.
That's what Jesus did. He broke down the middle wall of partition and division, yeah. made one new man. And in that new partnership, he made a new man, and that new man's anointed like him. And it's yeah. that literally fuels the new covenant.
Yes. Amen.
So praise the Lord,
Amen.
Man.
Amen.
It's happening today. Somebody's watching, and they're getting a breakthrough.
I believe that truly. So let me tell you this. I want to finish that story with the guy that I was talking about. He was there to receive that impartation
yeah.
from the help, from the cluster, right?
Yeah.
He was there that day because he had listened and esteemed the meeting. Yeah. In other words, I had told him about the meeting, and he said, you know what, I think I need to go to it. There was a life because somebody said, I think I need to go to a church
Hallelujah.
Meeting. And they listened to the Holy Ghost, but they esteemed, I need to be there. Had he not been there, it would not have happened
that way.
It would not.
Way.
That person would not have come back when they pulled the plug. The other thing was, he was there listening, and I could tell him what he was saying because he had esteemed to connect with
Absolutely.
Us.
Absolutely.
And he decided, I'm going to connect to Boomerang Church. I'm
Absolutely.
Going to connect to Pastor Brian, and I need to be there. When he decided to connect there, then we were talking. He heard that word to be there. Then he carried that anointing into that hospital
Glory
room.
God.
So a lot of times what happens is there's very simple things that people miss, and they are missing the power of God all the time. We don't want you to miss that kind of power
no
in your life.
Absolutely.
It may not be somebody that's related to you and as a friend. It may be you. It may be your family. It may be a coworker. It doesn't really matter. We just want to see the power of God released into your life all the time. And so that is connection. I believe that there's probably people out there that's saying, I'm supposed to connect with Brother Tracy, and you can go to experiencehim.org. Or I'm supposed to connect with Brian and Nicole at connectionshow.org or boomerangchurch.org. But here's the thing. The most important connection right now is that you are connected with Jesus Christ. And so no matter where you're at, before you do anything else, make a commitment. I'm going to connect with the people around me, but I'm going to also
Absolutely.
Connect with Jesus Christ. And just pray this with me. Say, Father, right now,
Father,
I make
right
Jesus
now.
The Lord of my life.
Thank you, Lord.
He's the director. He calls the shots, and I'm obedient. And I believe that He died for me,
Thank
that
Lord
God
Jesus.
Brought Him back to life
Hallelujah.
For me.
Absolutely.
And when He raised Jesus up, He raised me with Him. And now I am a new creation in Him. I am born again. I'm seated with Him in heavenly places. Jesus baptized me with the Holy Ghost and fire to be empowered to do what You've called me to do, to go and do exploits. And so, Father, we just thank You right now for everybody watching. Bless them. In
Jesus'
name, we thank You. Thank you for joining us on this episode of Connection. Go to connectshow.org. We love you. Have a great week.
Thank you for joining Brian and Nicole for this week's broadcast. Connection is all about connecting you more intimately with Jesus, where you can find true joy and really live. Contact us or watch more shows online at connectionshow.org. We love you. Have a great week.